song is called I Believe in You. And it's in English. Hoping to record it after the tour. Tonight's my grandfather's yahrzeit. Tonight's my grandfather's yahrzeit, Menachem Mendel ben Eliyahu. And in honor of him, it'd be amazing if we could take something upon ourselves. So there's an idea to say amen to a bracha, to a blessing. And that amen is actually more powerful than the blessing itself. That God created the world not for us to make blessings, but for one person to make a blessing on another person, to make an amen on another person's blessing. Amen, phonetically, if you say it fast enough, sounds like I'm in. So it sounds like we're saying, like, I'm in. Whatever you're aiming for, whatever you're saying, I believe in you. So I heard it said, the amazing thing about Hanukkah is that you can make a blessing on someone else's candles. That we think the world was created for us to make blessings, and that's a beautiful thing, but really, the world was created for us to see the blessings in other people's lives, to say a blessing when we're able to, and an amen when we're able to. So the thing about that idea, that if we want to live a real life, we should be into whatever the people we're spending the most time with are doing. So we should spend time with the people I can say amen to. I should marry someone, I want to say amen to everything they say, they do, and they hear, and they act. The way that they act, I wish I could say amen every time. Because they act like a blessing, they speak like a blessing, they think like blessings. They're bringing in blessings, they're expanding whatever we have in this world to work with, they're making it bigger and better and broader and more creative. They're expanding the world that we're living in, they're not contracting the world that we're living in. So you want to spend our time around expansive people, not confining people who limit us, and make us think in boxes, and make us think closed-mindedly, and make us cut off connections with other people. We should be blessed to be people who you could say amen to our actions, and to our words, and to our thoughts. And we should also spend time around people who we could say amen to all their actions, and words, and thoughts. And imagine, there's so many people who are committing suicide, there's so many people who don't believe that someone else believes in them. And if the Torah is trying to teach one thing, it's teaching one thing, v'ahavta l'recha kamocha, to love your fellow like you love yourself, on one foot, when all you have is one foot left, and your mamash running out, you're running out of Yiddishkeit, you're running as far as possible, and you're on one foot, and it's either you're going to stay in or out. Tell me what Torah is about. I'll tell you what it's about. It's about believing in each other. Believing in God is easy. Not many of us struggle that much with believing in God. You know what the hardest thing to struggle with is? Believing in yourself and believing in another, because that's really believing that God exists, is to believe that God's inside of each of us. And when we stop believing in ourselves, that's horrible. And we need friends who can believe in us. So I want to give everyone a blessing. It's unfortunate that the people who have left this world on their own volition didn't have the people around them just telling them how much they believe in them. And it's not them whose fault it is, it's our fault. We have to make the world a conducive place for growth and faith. Not just faith in God, but faith in each other. So please, let's start to develop a world that believes in each other. Not that's scrutinizing with each other. Not that's kicking another out of our life. Not that's telling that other person how off they are, but telling them how on they are, how right they are, how correct they are, how special they are, how precious they are, how valuable in our lives they are. And if that's the way we start to conduct ourselves and speak to one another, I'm certain that there won't be people ending their lives in their own volition. And it's in our hands. So let's be strong. Let's be strong on one thing. On taking care of each other. Chaim. first of all, I just want to say that Zach and all of us here, we believe in each and every one of you. We hope you believe in us. And please spread the message. Start believing in your friends. Tell them I believe in you. It could just very much change your life.